Om Shanti, today is the 140th day of your godly blessing, and here Baba shakes us up and tries to find out within ourselves, and he wants us to also find out within ourselves whether we have a true loving relationship with him or not. In devotion, we have been devoting our time in doing different types of penance, in doing different types of tapasya, in doing jap, sometimes tap, singing songs of praise of God, and even donating money to the mandir, to the gurudwara, to different places of worship. But is that enough? God says, if you are my devotee, then you are far away from me. But if you are my child, then you are the nearest to me. But you have to give a proof that you are my child and not just a devotee. A devotee will devote his time or time and want something in return from God. That I've done so much of puja, I've done so much of bhakti, give me something in return. But God says, that's not what I am, that's not my and your relationship. So let's find out what God wants us to do over here. So in this blessing, Baba says, may you be truly loving. Truly loving to whom? God the Father. And surrender everything of yours to the Father, in all forms and all relationship. Not even leave one thing for yourself. You can't say that this is mine. When we say that God has given us everything, we can't say this land has been given by God, but this portion is mine, I cannot give this out for seva, for godly work. You can't say that this money has been given by God, but I want to buy things for myself. I can't give out this money for doing seva or put it for the benefit of the world and my own brothers and sisters. When you have been given everything by God, even the food, you can't be going like, oh well, I cannot give anything in bhog for doing seva, for filling up the empty tummies of people around here. So Baba says, whomever you love, because if you have love with somebody, you would put everyone else aside for that person, for that love, and surrender everything of yours to that person. Don't we do that when we fall in love with somebody, or we love somebody? A child loving the parents, a parent loving his child, they will do anything for them, right? You'll leave everybody else, set everybody aside, and you'll focus on that child or that person, and you'll give away everything of yours to that person, right? So Baba says, similarly, the Father loves the children. Now God the Father loves the children, and so he enables all the loving children to have the attainment of everlasting happiness. Now, if we have love for the Father, that means we'll accept every godly guidance of God, which He's giving us in every vardhan, what to do, what not to do, in the murli, what to do, what not to do. In Brahmakumaris, the education is about cleansing our karmas. How do we do that? It's not just by tapasya, it's by knowing what is the right karma and what is the wrong karma, and what is a neutral karma. So God gives us the knowledge about all those things. So Baba says, He enables all the loving children to have the attainment of everlasting happiness. Conditions apply here. And sends everyone else to the land of liberation. So God, whom He chooses, He gives them the love and the happiness, because He understands that their heart is true, their mind is true, they are ready to give away everything, because they don't just say, this land has been given by God to me. And when it comes to having any kind of dispute on land, they are fighting with their neighbors, or they are quarreling with their neighbors, or with their family members, or with anybody in the world, for small petty things, be it land, be it property, be it money, be it jewelry, be it anything. We say it's been given by God, and when it comes to fighting a case, it's all about my or mine. God says, if you put it for good work, if you give it to God for good work, then all the quarrel finishes. What is mine? Nobody can fight with you for that purpose. The proof of love of such children is that they surrender everything of theirs to the Father in all forms and all relationships. They don't even keep anything for themselves. They're like, if I give it away for everything for God's work, it automatically is mine, because that is being given by God to me for putting it for the right work. If your physical father gives you money, you'll make sure that you put it for the right work, and that money will benefit your family and the whole family. Won't you do that? Or you'll just spend it away and spend it in the wrong manner, in a wrong way, that will bring about any form of trouble to the family. You won't do that, right? That's the difference between a good child and a child who doesn't listen to the father. So father says the same thing over here. Where there is love, there is yoga. Yoga means you are in love with God. You have connection with God. And where there is yoga, there is cooperation. Cooperation means you'll get help from God because you are in connection with God. You cannot then waste a single treasure due to following the dictates of your own mind. When we follow the dictates of our own mind, let's say for example, God has given us a property and God says, my child, open up one room for doing seva. Help other souls to learn meditation and also help other souls to come in connection with God. But you say, well, God, I want to use this property or this small room for my own business, for my own purpose, for my own earning. God says, are you listening to me? Because I have given you this thing. And you say that, God, you have given me everything. Then why can't that be put for God's purpose? Why can't that be used for a higher purpose? In which, whose benefit is it? It is our own benefit, right? So God says, when I show you that you are going to benefit out of it, but you use your own mind's dictates, you use greed or you use ego by saying it's my. But in front of others, in front of other people, you say everything is being given by God to me. And if everything is given by God and God says, why don't you use it for the good purpose of humanity? And that's the time we are tested. Either we are those bhagat, those devotees who say everything is being given by God to me, or we act like God's child. There's a big difference between a devotee and someone who feels that I am God's child. So devotee would say everything is given by God, but some of them will not use that wealth or that property or land or anything for the purpose of helping others. Whereas a child would say everything has been given by God to me and everybody is God's child. So let me utilize everything which been given to me by God as the eldest brother or sister and share it with my other brothers and sisters for their own purpose. So it's not about willing it to other people. It's not willing it to all the world, your property and all. It's about putting it at use, for the right use, for let's say opening a meditation center, for let's say having people come for a gathering and listening to godly versions and making the mind peaceful and learning meditation, many more things. Just an example of how you can turn everything given by God for the right purpose in the right direction. So then God says, you cannot then waste a single treasure due to following dictates of your own mind. Even this knowledge cannot be wasted. You cannot use this knowledge to earn name and fame for yourself or money for yourself. That's what God says. God says, don't impurify this knowledge. Don't earn the name and fame in this world by using this knowledge. This knowledge is to help others and it's not there to make you rich or popular. That's not God's work. God says, you will become popular and rich in the future. But if you try to become popular and rich in this life itself by using this knowledge and trying to gain popularity, then you are not using the means which have been given by God in the right manner, the right way. You're impurifying that too. So I leave you with this beautiful blessing. Think about it, contemplate about it, learn the ways of God by learning how God wants us to live at Brahmakumaris. I leave you with this. Have a blessed day. Stay safe. Stay home. Om Shanti.